Today I will explain about hierarchical inheritance in C++. Okay, how it will be implemented in C++. In last video I talked about multi-level inheritance and multiple inheritance in C++. I covered these two concepts in last video. In today video I will explain about what the hierarchical inheritance in C++. What is hierarchical inheritance in C++? Here, what is importance of hierarchical inheritance in C++? First, I will give the definition of the hierarchical inheritance. After that, I will give the real-time example about the hierarchical inheritance. After that, I will write the syntax, then I will give the example, which means that how the hierarchical inheritance concept is implemented in C++. Okay, but what is hierarchical inheritance? Then the hierarchical inheritance is nothing but, because you create two or more derived classes from the same parent class or same base class to the mechanism of create or derive two or more derived classes or child classes from same parent or base class is called as what? Hierarchical because the mechanism create two or more derived classes from the same parent class or same base class is called as hierarchical inheritance, which means that the parent is same, parent is class is only one, you can able to derive n number of derived classes because two or more derived classes from the same parent class is the concept of hierarchical inheritance, which means that how we are going to represent the hierarchical inheritance in a diagram. For example, here is the base class. Sub B, then C, D, E. All these are what? Derived classes. Derived classes. This is because as per the definition of hierarchical inheritance, to create two or more derived classes from the same base class is called as what? Hierarchical inheritance. For this diagram, one base class is A. By using the base class, you create the derived class B. The C class has also created from class A. The D class has also created from class A. The E class has also created from class A. How many derived classes are there? 4 derived classes. How many base classes are there? Only 1 base class. Here you can create a number of derived classes from the same parent class or same base class. That concept is called as hierarchical inheritance. The real time example of hierarchical inheritance is, suppose the father, for example, I will write a father because son 1, for example, son 2. Father is the what? Parent class. They are both are what? Child classes or derived classes. Here the base class is also called as super class or parent class. The derived classes are also called as what? The subclasses or child classes. Here the father is a parent. The son 1 has created from father. The son 2 class has created from father. Here what happens is that the both son 1 and son 2, both classes can access the properties from what? Is it able to access the properties from father class? The son 2 can also access the properties from father class. Here the son 1 and son 2 both are accessing from what? Father. I hope it is clear. Here the father, the son. For example, the both classes, father is consistent, is having the two sons, but the two sons having the right to access the properties from father. Both sons can access the properties from father. I hope it is clear. Then for example, another example I am going to give you, then see. Then programming languages are derived from the languages. Then C is a language. Then Java. Suppose C++. Because this is the parent class or base class, they are directly derived classes. Here the C, some futures can be derived, the Java can derive some futures from C, the C++ also can derive some futures from C. For data type concept is there, the variable concept is there, here both are derived from C. The pointer concept is there, some futures can be derived from C. C is the basic for Java language and C++. Okay, C++ language can be derived from C. The Java language is derived from C because some features can derive from C. That's like you take any example, but here how the hierarchical inheritance can be represented in these diagrams. Then what is the syntax? For example, two classes are there. I created for two classes, because if you create a number of classes, you take the length of the program will be increased. That's why I have taken two classes. Here, what is the syntax for it? These two are the derived classes. What is the syntax? Class A. Class A is over. This is called members of A. Then semicolon. Then class B is derived from A. The class B, they support public A. Because B is derived from A. Semicolon. Members of B. Then the class C is also derived from A. Class C, public or private or protected, A. the B and C has derived from A. Members of C. Look at here. This is called as the base class. Base class as defined here. The class B has declared using what? Base class. The class B is derived from A. What are the members B1 declared, which are belongs to what? Class B. The class B is also derived from what? A. They are the members of A. Because the class B can access the properties from class A. The class C is also access the properties from class A. Okay, that concept is called as hierarchical inheritance. Now, I will tell you how it can be implemented in C++. I retain the syntax for hierarchical inheritance concept. Then, I will write the example for hierarchical inheritance. Okay? I think everybody is clear. Just wait a second, I will write the example. I will write the simple example, it can easily understand to you. Example, then first base class, base class name is shape, it has protected because if it declares a private which can't be inherited in the derived class, the private that is not accessible in the derived class, you know it. Int length, int breadth, because you can declare over here also, comma breadth, because I want to use this space, that's why I written over here. Three data members have been declared under the protected. Then public void. Set data into A into B here the length equal to L, breadth equal to B. After that, I want to take Y. Set data. Set radius. RE. I equal to RE, then class will be closed.
Yeah.
This is called as what? Base class. I have taken three data members. Three data members. Under the public, I have taken another member function, set data. In the set data method, I insulate the length and breadth. The length equal to L because these values you have taken from the main function. Breadth equal to B, then semicolon. Then set radius, the radius also initialized over here. After that, I want to create the two derived classes. The class rectangle, then public quad, public shape, here public y, find, not find rectangle area. In that, see out area of rectangle plus, sorry, this is not plus, length into breadth. Then function will be close. Then class will be close. After that, then class circle public shape. Then public white circle area, see out area of circle, phi r square. What is the phi value of, what is the phi value is? Phi value is 3.14. 3.14, then R, phi r square. Then function will be closed. Look at here. The shape is the base class. From which we have created two derived classes. One is rectangle. Another one is circle. Is it hierarchical? Yes. The two derived classes are created from the same parent class. The rectangle class is created from shape class. The circle class has also created from shape class. Then the rectangle class, it is adding one method, rectangle area, area of rectangle, length and breadth. Then I want to write my main function. You create the object for which class? You create the object for rectangle class, you should create the object for circle class. The rectangle, no need to create for the shape class. R dot set data, because length and breadth which are required for to find the area of rectangle. Set data. Then R dot to call the rectangle area. The Then you should, after that you should create the object for the circle. Circle is C. C dot set radius. It is a one argument, suppose 5. Here also two arguments you should pass over. 3.6. Then C dot, what is called hypercircle area. Now, this is a simple example about the hierarchical inheritance in C++. This is the base class. It has set theta and set radius. Okay, set theta length and breadth. Suppose, for example, object has created for R. Rectangle class, how many data members have the length, breadth, R? Because in that one, length, breadth, then what is called R? Because R value is not initialized here, it is 0. Length value is what? R dot set data, because L value becomes 3. B will become 6. Then the 3 will be copied. L will be copied in the length here. Length data member. The B will is copied into the breadth data member. Here length is 3. Breadth value becomes 6. The R value is not initialized. At this time R value becomes still 0 only. Then circle C. The R dot rectangle area. Then control will come to here. Because the rectangle area R value is not there. But rectangle area of rectangle equal length, what is the length value is 3. What is the breadth value becomes 6. Because we have created the object for the rectangle area, we can, by using the object of R, we can access set data method and radius also, but the radius is not required for us. Just we invoke only set data method. Set data method, after you call the rectangle area, then control will comes to here. The length value and breadth value should be evaluated. Then what is the result? AID. AID will be displayed on the output device. Then object is created for the circle. Then C dot set radius. Then it will come to here. Phi value, this is the phi, RE value becomes phi. The RE is value will be stored in the variable R. Then C value object, what is the R value becomes what? Phi. Then C is dot circle area. Then which will comes to here, area of circle equal 3.14. Then R value becomes phi. And 3.14 into phi into fine. Then you just get the output. Here, the concept is that the two classes have been derived from the class shape. Then, how the rectangle class can access the properties from shape, the circle class can access the properties from shape. Here, what are the access, what are the properties that are accessed by the rectangle class or circle class? The rectangle class can access the length and breadth and also set data. These are two data members, one member function can be accessed by the rectangle class. In case of circle class, which is accessing by the radius R and set radius. These two properties can be accessed by the circle class. These three properties can be accessed by the rectangle class. This concept is called as what? Hierarchical inheritance. I hope it is clear to everyone. If you get any kind of doubt regarding the inheritance concept, just post your query in chat box window, then I will resolve your problem. Or else, if you want to write any kind of program using hierarchical inheritance, just post in chat box window, I will implement that kind of program. Thank you for watching my videos. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel and send your comment. Thank you, thank you very much.